Today we are going to discuss about transportation video series, in which today's topic is IBFS by LC, means initial basic feasible solution by least cost method, or sometimes it is called as the lowest cost method. So welcome to my YouTube channel Mechanical Engineering Management. Like, share and subscribe. So let's take example. Consider the transportation problem shown in table below. Find the initial basic feasible solution using LC method. So this table is given to you. So here our objective is to find only initial basic feasible solution by LC method. So you know that there are basically three different IBFS method, but here in the description it is mentioned that you have to follow the LC method only to find the IBFS. Now once again revise these steps for the transportation problem. So let's follow one by one all these steps. So first prepare the table. So that is already in the standard form. So here you can see factory having different supply, or you can say different capacity, destination having different demand, and these are the transportation costs. So already it is in the tabular form. Next, convert maximization to minimization. Here by default you can assume transportation problem is a minimization. If it is not mentioned in the description about the maximization or minimization. Third one, convert unbalanced to balance. So for that you have to calculate the total demand, summation of these all demand, and that is your total demand. So here in this problem it is 15,500. Now calculate total supply. So the summation of these all values, and that will be 20,000. So here if you look at these two values, then you can conclude that in this problem total demand is not equal to total supply, and so that this problem is the unbalanced problem. So first you need to convert from unbalanced to balanced problem. So now we are going to convert from unbalanced to balanced one. So here you can see in this figure I have added the dummy column because there is a shortage of 4,500 in the demand, and so that I have created one dummy retail shop having demand 4,500, and so that the corresponding transportation cost is zero. So now it is balance problem. Now next step, find IBFS by any of these three method. So here we are going to follow the LC, means lowest cost method. So first the concept of lowest cost. So name itself indicate you have to select the lowest cost from all these available transportation routes. So here you can see there are four different routes in this particular column having zero cost, means minimum cost. So I can select anyone, but you have to prefer the route having maximum allocation. See, if I select over here, then I can allocate here the minimum of these two value, that means 3000. If I select this, then I can allocate the minimum value of these two, that means 4500. So I should give the priority to this cell rather than this one. Now if you look at this one, then once again it is 4500, and if you look at this one, then it will be 3750. Once again there is a tie between these two cells, because of in both the cells you can allocate the 4500 quantities. So you can select arbitrarily anyone out of these two. So here I am going to select this one. Now you have to follow these three different steps in sequence. So I have completed first allocation. Now modification to corresponding supply and demand. So here I have allocated 4500 quantities, and so that I can say from the origin 2 I have supplied 4500 quantity to dummy retail shop, and so that I can say this demand is satisfied, and over here still 500 capacity at destination 2 is remaining. So I can cancel it because of the demand is satisfied at dummy retail shop. Now repeat the step. So select the minimum cost out of these remaining cells. So here this one is having minimum cost, and so that I can allocate over here. Now look at the corresponding supply and demand. So the minimum of these two, that is 3000. So I can allocate 3000 over here. Now modified in corresponding supply and demand. So here it will be modified, and here 1000 is still remaining. So here you can see the capacity of origin 1 is over. So I can cancel it. Now once again select the minimum cost out of this remaining cells. So here 8 is the minimum cost, and so that I can allocate over here. So look at the corresponding supply and demand and select the minimum out of these two value. So 1000 is the allocation. Now modified supply and demand. So I have modified, and so that it will be cancelled. Now once again select the minimum cost. So this 12 is the minimum cost, and so that I can allocate the minimum value from corresponding supply and demand. So it will be 500 modified. So it will be cancelled. Now once again select the minimum cost. Here there is a tie. So at that time you have to prefer the maximum allocation. So if you try to allocate over here, then it will be the 3000 over here. If you allocate over here, then it will be only 1500. This cell having the maximum allocation. So it should be your preference. So here I can allocate 3000. Now modified at both supply and demand, and so that it will be cancelled. Now select the minimum cost. So here it is the minimum cost, and so that I can allocate 1500, because of that is the minimum value from this corresponding supply and demand. Now modified supply and demand, and so that it will be cancelled. Now select the minimum value out of these four. So this one is the minimum value. So I can allocate over here minimum of these two, that is 4000. Modified supply and demand, and so that it will be cancelled. Now here single column is remain, and so that directly you can allocate. So if I want to allocate over here, then the minimum value from these two is 250. So allocate over here 250. Modified the supply and demand so that it will be cancelled. Now next over here, look at this one is the last cell, and it should be the same value, so that you can ensure that the whole procedure can be right. So here I can allocate 2250. So it is very simple logic. Name itself indicate least cost. So you have to select the route having least cost value, and you can repeat this step. So if I want to find at last the total cost, then it will be 4 into 3000, then 12 into 500, then 0 into 4500, then 16 into 3000, then 8 into 1000, then 28 into 250, plus 20 into 4000, plus 40 into 2250, plus 16 into 1500. And so that it will be 2,75,000 rupees. So thanks my dear friends, press the like button to appreciate this video.